Well, my friends, I come before you with bad news. Those of you who love Star Wars, those of me who used to like Star Wars, well, I say used to because, let's face it, it's all over for Star Wars. We thought, we really hoped against hope that after the flop that was Solo and the disappointment of The Last Jedi, that Kathleen Kennedy would be somehow removed from Lucasfilm, removed from Disney, and no longer had any power or influence over the franchise. Well, we find out that that is just not the case. As a matter of fact, her contract has actually been extended now for 3 more years. 3 more years. We have to wait until 2021 before Kathleen Kennedy is officially gone. So who knows how much more damage she could do in those 3 years. Could she make things any worse than she already has after the flop of The Last Jedi, the complete failure of Solo, the disaster that is the new Star Wars Resistance series? I don't know how much worse it could possibly get. Well, we do know that, and this just basically comes only about a week or so after we had heard that Bob Iger had announced that Disney would slow down on Star Wars. Slow things down. Allow some breathing room between these films, which was actually a good idea. It was a good idea, but unfortunately, somebody at Disney probably blackmailed him into letting Kathleen Kennedy keep her job. I mean, come on, Iger. What was it really? Was it blackmail? Did Kathleen Kennedy have pictures of you in the nude having non-consensual sex with a possum? What was it? Or are you just a cucked up beta male? In any case, this spells doom for the once beloved franchise. I really think that this franchise is beyond saving now. There's nothing that can bring it back from the brink. Because Disney keeps making mistake after mistake. I've already talked about The Last Jedi. I've already talked about Solo. And now the Resistance cartoon series, which is cheaply animated, well voice acted, but cheaply animated, and also is supposedly marketed for little kids. But there's a problem. It airs on the Disney Channel at 10 p.m. on Sunday nights. Sunday nights! Yes, when all the little kiddies are getting ready for bed because they gotta get up early in the morning to go to school, I suppose. How are they gonna be able to stay up to watch this thing? You made a show that is on too late on the wrong day for your target audience, Disney. Jesus, are you stupid? Jeez. Did Bob Iger shove the mouse up his butt again or something? I don't know. I just don't know what's going on anymore with Disney. I'm more of a Looney Tunes guy myself. I'm more into DC superheroes, as you can see with the Batman poster there. I'm not really happy about Disney anymore. I have no faith in them. They've ruined Marvel as well. Maybe I'll do a video on Marvel, but for right now we're focusing on Star Wars and what's going on here. So Star Wars is officially screwed over. Screwed over royally for the next 3 years. You see, as I had said, during the time of the failure, in the wake of the failure of Solo, we honestly thought that, yeah, this is the death knell for Kathleen Kennedy, that she will be fired, and we thought, yeah, she'll be out by September. Well, here it is, the end of September, and unfortunately, yeah, she's staying for another 3 years. So, tough luck, Dave Filoni. I guess we're not going to get the Clone Wars series after all. I guess we're going to get more junk, including possibly Rian Johnson's trilogy. And just after Disney had announced they were canceling that too. Again, Disney, do you ever learn anything from your mistakes? I think the answer is obvious. No, they don't. I don't know what to think anymore. I really don't know what to think. I think we've lost Star Wars for good. As we speak, I'm actually working on two other videos right now. The other video, the first video I'm working on, is actually why Star Wars toys are not selling anymore. We know the reasons why, and I'm only going to three places to check it out. So that video probably will be relatively short. And also, I have some tragic news to report. More tragic news, really. Gary Kurtz, the beloved producer and executive producer of the first two films, A New Hope and Return, The Empire Strikes Back, has died. I mean, this guy was basically Lucas's right-hand man ever since they worked on American Graffiti together. They worked on American Graffiti, the original Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, The Dark Crystal for Jim Henson, and a slew of other projects whom right now I can't remember, but one thing is for sure, we're gonna really miss Gary Kurtz. He was definitely Lucas's right-hand man and voice of reason. I am also, as of now, working on a very short video about that as well. So you can probably catch that, probably by the same, later than late the following day after I've posted this. Anyway, just to let you know, I think Star Wars is beyond saving. At least until Kathleen Kennedy is gone in 3 years. It's a shame to see such a once powerful franchise end. I've already detailed all this stuff, you know, in my SJN did the SJWs and Disney kill Star Wars video earlier this year. And that's about all I have to say on the subject. It's not good news. Not good news at all. In the words of my best friend Doomcock, stay angry.